When we say throat cancer, we're really talking about a variety of malignancies that can occur from the oral cavity or mouth on into the pharynx or back of the throat or down in the larynx or voice box. And we can expand that discussion even further to talk about the groups of tumors that are collectively called head and neck cancer. And this includes the various throat cancers plus tumors in the thyroid gland, the salivary glands, the lymph nodes, or even the skin of the head and neck. There are several signs or symptoms that can be very concerning for the development of head and neck cancer. One of them is hoarseness. Now, everybody can become hoarse from time to time, associated with a cold or something like that. But hoarseness that's persistent, say for a month or so, really should be evaluated by an otolaryngologist, head and neck surgeon, commonly called an ear, nose, and throat physician. Another worrisome symptom would be dysphagia, or trouble swallowing, particularly trouble swallowing solids, or if it's associated with what we call odynophagia, which means pain with swallowing. Another potential worrisome sign for throat cancer is a non-healing sore or a lump in the neck. And this can be an area in the mouth that stays raw, doesn't want to heal, or a lump that's an enlarged lymph node or maybe other mass in the neck. Now, lymph nodes will typically become enlarged temporarily after a throat infection, and they're usually tender when that occurs. But a persistently enlarged lymph node, one that exists for about 6 weeks or so, really should be evaluated further. And lymph nodes that are associated with cancer are usually painless rather than being tender to the touch. Hemoptysis, or coughing up blood, is always a very concerning symptom, and that's something that should definitely be talked about with a physician. Dyspnea, or shortness of breath, can also be an indication of a throat cancer. Usually that won't happen, though, until a tumor is actually quite large and is beginning to obstruct part of the breathing passage. Otalgia, or ear pain, with a normal ear exam, is also a concerning symptom. It's not very intuitive, but ear pain may actually be referred pain that's coming from a lesion that's in the larynx or the voice box or the back of the throat. So if the ear looks normal and there's persistent ear pain, that's something that needs to be further evaluated. The primary risk factors associated with throat cancer are tobacco use or alcohol abuse. And tobacco use includes smoking or chewing tobacco. And the combination of tobacco use and alcohol abuse is a very potent combination of risk factors for developing throat cancer. Other risk factors that we're learning more about now are HPV, or human papillomavirus, and even chronic acid reflux. As far as preventative measures, our research here at the University of Michigan and the research of others have shown that fruit and vegetable intake is associated with a lower risk of developing throat cancer and better outcomes in patients who do develop cancers. Soy is also associated with a better outcome. Having said that, though, the key preventative steps for preventing throat cancer are don't use tobacco and don't abuse alcohol. Here at the University of Michigan, we have a well-established multidisciplinary head and neck oncology program for the evaluation and treatment of patients with head and neck cancer. And this includes a very active research arm that's exploring the fundamental biology of these lesions as well as new treatment modalities. A patient evaluation will typically begin with a referral by a primary care or other physician to an otolaryngologist head and neck surgeon, commonly called an ear, nose, and throat physician. The office evaluation includes a detailed medical history as well as a complete head and neck examination. And the exam will also typically involve an office endoscopy using an instrument like this to look in the back of the throat and down in the voice box. This can be done very effectively and painlessly in the outpatient clinic. If there is a suspicious lesion seen on the exam, typically a biopsy either in the operating room or possibly in the clinic will follow. Similar to other cancers, the three main treatment modalities for head and neck cancer are surgery, radiation therapy, and chemotherapy. And particularly for more advanced lesions, these treatments are often used in combination. Our institution has been a leader in the development of organ-sparing treatments for head and neck cancer using chemotherapy and radiation therapy. We also offer state-of-the-art surgical treatment, reconstructive options, and all-important rehabilitation after the cancer treatment itself is completed. Head and neck cancer is definitely a field where optimum outcomes require a well-organized, multidisciplinary treatment approach. We are very committed to compassionate, individualized care that takes into account the specific patient as well as their tumor. This is another example of the Michigan difference. If you were to ask me for a few key points about throat cancer, I would say, number one, don't use tobacco and don't abuse alcohol. Number two, if you develop any of the warning signs, you should be evaluated by an otolaryngologist. And number three, if you are diagnosed with a throat cancer, you should be certain that your treatment is through an institution that is experienced in the multidisciplinary approach to head and neck cancer.